First of all, the President, the forecast that we had this time with the package of 60 million is the second time that we have such an arrangement. The first forecast arrangement started 3 years ago and then started in 2015 and also included 60 billion funding package for Africa. This is the second time now that we have a 60 billion package offered to Africa. But what is important is that the split has changed. Now let me start with the carbon problem. We have within the 60 billion, 15 billion is earmarked for grants, interest-free loans, and concessional loans. In the previous one, that composed 35 billion. So there, the concession loans has been changed quite significantly. There's a new category in this FOCA, which is credit lines, 20 billion. It was not in the previous one. Then there's a new package, which is a special fund for development financing, 10 billion. A very interesting one, President, is a special fund for financing imports from Africa. So it is not an export facilitating fund for Chinese entities. It is to assist African commodities to go to China. It will be funded to export 5 billion. And then there is, again, President, I think in reaction to our quest for having real investments done, an amount of 10 billion earmarked to fund investments in Africa. Now that's the split of the 60 billion. The areas of cooperation span 8 broad areas that include economic, financial, social, etc., security components. In the economic sphere, these areas include culture, infrastructure development, industrial capacity, and so on, energy, natural resources, tourism, and trade. Those are the elements that are the economic elements to be funded with any of these aspects within the 60 billion. President, the typical loan terms for concessional loans from China are loans that come at an interest rate of 2%. They have a grace period of 5 years. This time around, they offered a blend with grants, typically of the total project cost, 10% would be grant funded and 90% would have been the concession loan. And then there is a 0.25% management fee. Now if we compare that to other debt instruments that we currently use, just for comparison, let's say, we pay for domestic debt, that is for treasury bills, that comes at a cost of 7.7%. Bonds come at 9%. The euro bonds that we have taken up and the African development bonds come in at 7%. So the concessionality of the Chinese loan is significantly cheaper than what we have on the books for now. So the concessionality is real. It's what it says. Mr. President, the provisions for this funding is for project financing. There is no budget support offered, so we are not able to utilize, nor that we want to utilize these loans for operational expenditure. It's purely for said, there's project funding. And these projects need to be agreed bilaterally with China before the loan is eventually agreed upon. For now, we have not signed any loan. What we have done during this focus meeting, the bilateral meeting we had with China, we have indicated projects that we believe are priority projects that could attract funding and which we would request. One of them is what you have proposed already, it's the upgrading of the airport, which is a priority item. But it is not yet agreed as to the scope, the size, and to what extent the loan amount would be. So that is unfolding in discussions as follow-up to the FOCA. But it would be fitting under the FOCA framework, a protocol like this. The indication is also that the Chinese are very much interested in public-private partnership. That would be on the investment side, where they either go and assist and come to our economy as direct investments, direct foreign investments, or through public-private partnerships. Both areas are of interest to the Chinese party, and they have indicated to now prepare to have projects that fit that. The President, I want to emphasize that our national debt is managed within a sovereign debt strategy. The exposure we have to China at the moment is 2 billion, or about 2.6% of total debt, or 7.9% of the foreign debt profile. This is a low exposure to one specific currency, and the debt composes of 302 million as an interest-free loan and 1.6 billion concessional loans. That's what we have borrowed from China. 302 million as an interest-free loan